tonight, after the sun has set on this holy Saturday, the Church of God gathers in darkness. At first, it feels like the same darkness that we have experienced over the past 2 days, since the curtain of the temple was torn in two and darkness covered the whole land. But this darkness tonight is different, for in that deep, dark void, we see light. And what dawns on us is the truth that God has acted decisively. God has done a new thing, a glorious thing. For Jesus the Christ, who had been crucified and died and been laid in a tomb, this same Jesus now lives again. So let us rejoice and be exceedingly glad. Let the whole church sing songs of joy and praise this night. Even the trees of the field clap their hands, and the mountains and the hills break forth into song. For Jesus lives. My friends, I had hoped to be with you in person tonight, on this night of all nights. I had hoped that we could all gather together at the Church of St. Bartholomew in Regent Park, huddled there together as the first flicker of resurrection light was kindled in the darkness, proclaiming the Exultet, that great Easter anthem, gathering around the font to renew our life together in baptism, and then once again at the altar, where we recall that Christ's perfect sacrifice for us opens the way to abundant life for us in the here and now, and eternal life in the hereafter. I so wish we could all be there. Father Hannum tells me that there are just 5 of you at the church tonight. That's all we're permitted under the current restrictions. To the 5 of you, thank you for being there on our behalf and allowing us to join in this celebration from our own homes. My friends, these past few weeks have been very difficult. We have been isolated from one another, kept away from the sacraments of the church, unable to pray together side by side, or serve the most vulnerable in the ways that are most effective. Life is not as it should be. And for the foreseeable future, our church buildings may remain shuttered, our organs and choirs silent, our once busy sidewalk along Dundas Street empty, and our friends and neighbors apparent to us only from a distance. But the Easter gospel that we proclaim once again tonight cannot be contained or distanced. It doesn't reside in any church or cathedral. Its efficacy does not depend on us gathering for worship in any particular place. Rather, it is a sound that has gone out into all lands, a message to the ends of the earth. And for those of us who commit our lives to the one who was crucified on Good Friday and has been raised again today, our task is to go out into the world to be the church, in good times and in bad, in darkness and in light. Our work, our ministry, our Easter proclamation is more vital now than ever before. And the good news of God's saving love in Christ is to be heard on every continent and island, on every city sidewalk and street corner. So be of good courage. On this holy night in which we remember our Passover from death to life, go out into the world safely, to practice resurrection. Be agents of Christ's liberating love. This is the night that Christ triumphed over death. Our Paschal Lamb has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. And now, may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, equip you with everything good that you may do his will, working in you that which is pleasing in his sight. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day of resurrection and remain with you forevermore. Amen.
Kindle light to light upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in the which is the fruit of a tree yielding seed, to you it shall be meat. And to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth, whether in this life I have given every green herb for me. And it was so. And God saw everything that he made, and behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. And on the seventh day God ended his work which he had made, and he rested on the seventh day from all his work which he had made. Let us pray. Let us bow the knee. O God, who in a wondrous manner didst create the race of men, and still more wondrously hast redeemed the same, grant us, we beseech thee, so steadfastly to withstand all the crafts and devices of sin, that we may be found worthy to attain to everlasting felicity. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
And it came to pass that in the morning watch, the Lord looked at
And in that day seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, We will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach. In that day shall the branch of the Lord be beautiful and glorious, and the fruit of the earth shall be excellent and comely for them that are escaped of Israel. And it shall come to pass that he that is left in Zion and he that remaineth in Jerusalem shall be called holy, even every one that is written among them, among the living in Jerusalem. When the Lord shall have washed away the filth of the daughters of Zion, and shall have purged the blood of Jerusalem from the midst thereof by the spirit of judgment and by the spirit of burning, and the Lord will create upon every dwelling place of Mount Zion and upon her assemblies a cloud and smoke by day, and the shining of a flaming fire by night. For upon all the glory shall be a defense, and there shall be a tabernacle for a shadow in the daytime from the heat, and for a place of refuge, and for a covert from storm and from rain.
My well-beloved hath a vineyard in a very fruitful hill.
And he fenced it, and gathered out the stones thereof, and planted it with the choicest vine, and built a tower in the midst of it.
And also made a wine press therein. For the vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
Let us pray. Let us bow the knee. Arise. O God, by the mouth of thy holy prophets, hast manifested thyself before all the children of the church, to be in all places of thy dominion, to be the sower of good seed and the husbandman of thine elect branches. Grant unto thy people that the vineyard of thy planting and the harvest of thy sowing, being purged of all thorns and briars, they may be made to bring forth worthy fruit in abundance. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Moses therefore wrote this song the same day, and taught it the children of Israel. And he gave Joshua the son of Nun a charge, and said, Be strong and of a good courage, for thou shalt bring the children of Israel into the land which I swear unto them, and I will be with thee. And it came to pass, when Moses had made an end of writing the words of this law in a book, until they were finished, that Moses commanded the Levites, which bear the ark of the covenant of the Lord, saying, Take this book of the law, and put it in the side of the ark of the covenant of the Lord your God, that it may be there for a witness against thee. For I know thy rebellion and thy stiff neck. Behold, while I am yet alive with you this day, ye have been rebellious against the Lord, and how much more after my death. Gather unto me all the elders of your tribes and your officers, that I may speak these words in their ears, and call heaven and earth to record to provoke him to anger through the work of your hands. And Moses spake in the ears of all the congregation of Israel the words of this song, until they were rendered.
Drop as the rain from heaven.
and desiring the fountain of thy waters, even as thou art desiring the water. And of thy goodness grant that they who thirst after the faith may in this mystery of thy holy baptism obtain sanctification both of body and soul. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one Lord, world without end.
Amen.
And for the regeneration of these persons now seeking to be born again in the waters of baptism, send forth upon them the spirit of adoption, and that this office and ministry of us, thine unworthy servants, may effectually be fulfilled in them by thy mighty power, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, forever and ever, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty, everlasting God, who working by thine invisible power, dost wonderfully bestow upon thy servants effectual means of grace. And though we be unworthy to be partakers of these holy mysteries, thou leadest us not destitute of thy gifts of grace, but mercifully inclinest thine ear to our supplications. O God, whose Spirit moved over the waters, when the earth was without form and void at its creation, that even then the face of the waters might receive the virtue of purging all defilements. O God, who for the destruction of sinners did at once drown all the world, and by the saving of eight persons, they show forth in a figure our regeneration. That by the mystery of this one element of water, thou mightest make an end of sin, and give birth unto righteousness. Regard favorably, O Lord, the prayers of this thy family, and make the grace of thy regeneration to abound in us, that thou dost with the rivers of thy plenteous mercy make glad the city of thy redeeming, and openest unto us the fountains of blessing through the whole world for the healing of nations, that at the word of thy majesty grace may be bestowed on it from thine only Son, through the Holy Ghost. May he sanctify by the secret operation of his power a spot of defilement. It may be found a new creature that springeth from the living water, that young and old, both men and women, that henceforth shall be baptized herein, may all become thy children and heirs of thy heavenly promises. Speak the word, O Lord, and drive away speedily unclean spirits, and all things that may hurt us, banish from us, by thy name all the snares and assaults of the devil. And may our ghostly enemy have no power at all to encompass us, to deceive our hearts by his subtlety, to waylay us in secret, and to spread abroad the leaven of malice. May this holy and undefiled creation, seeing that the son of wickedness may not approach it, nor the stain of iniquity come near to defile it, be a fountain that doth regenerate, streams that do purify. May all they that by this means shall be dedicated before them, by the operation of the Holy Ghost, receive the grace of redemption and remission of their offenses. Therefore do I hallow thee, O thou gift of water, my God that live, my God the faithful, my God the holy. My God who in the beginning, by his word divided the land from thee, by whose spirit the waters were overshadowed. Would it ordain that thou shouldst issue out of Eden and be parted from thence diversely, giving plenty to all his creation? Likewise in the desert of Mara, he did turn thy bitterness into sweetness and made thee to come forth out of the rock for his people. In the name of his only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, do I hallow thee, gift of water, for he did change thee into wine in proof of his omnipotence, when he was bidden to the wedding at Cana, who walked upon thee to his disciples, and was baptized in thee in Jordan, making John his minister. Moreover, did mingle thee with blood from his side at his passion, and commanded his faithful servants that believing they should be washed in thee, saying, know thee and teach all nations, and baptize them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Almighty God, mercifully assist our prayers, who here observe these thy commandments, and of thy great goodness prosper our petition. Enable by thy word and power the weakness of this water, that like as by nature it do its service unto the purifying of the body, so by thy grace it may effectually cleanse our soul. May the power of the Holy Ghost be poured out upon this font we have filled. May the power of the Holy Ghost be poured out upon this font we have filled. May the power of the Holy Ghost be poured out on this font we have filled. this water to be effectual unto the washing away of transgression. May every stain of our iniquity here be cleansed. May our nature be restored to its perfect fashion, and be conformed again to thine own image of righteousness. May it be redeemed from the old sins of its conversation. Let every person being born again by the sacrament he hath here received, may be restored verily unto the innocence of thy children. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who shall come to judge the quick and the dead, and the world by fire.
Amen. Amen.
May this oil of salvation make this font holy and cause it to multiply, that those who find herein their new birth may come to life everlasting.
Amen.
Amen.
May this mingling of the chrism of Jesus Christ, our Lord, and of the Holy Ghost, the Paraclete, be wrought in the name of the Most Holy Trinity.
Amen.
Amen.
May this mingling of the chrism of salvation and the oil of unction and of the water of baptism likewise be wrought in the name of the Father. And of the Son. And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
On this most holy night, dearly beloved brethren, our Holy Mother the Church, calling to mind the death and burial of our Lord Jesus Christ, rendereth unto him love for love and keepeth vigil, and awaiting his glorious resurrection, rejoiceth with great gladness. But since, as the Apostle teacheth us, we are buried with Christ by baptism into his death, like as Christ was raised up from the dead, even so we should walk in newness of life. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that henceforth we should not serve sin. Let us reckon ourselves therefore to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Wherefore, dearly beloved brethren, now that our Lenten exercises are over, let us renew the promises made in holy baptism, whereby we once renounced Satan and all his works, and likewise the world which is the enemy of God, promise to serve God faithfully in his holy church. I demand, therefore, do ye renounce the devil and all his works, the vain pomp and glory of the world with all the covetous desires of the same, and the carnal desires of the flesh, so that ye will not follow nor be led by them.
We renounce them all.
Do ye believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, our Lord, and that he was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, that he suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried, that he went down into hell, and also did rise again the third day, that he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty, and from thence shall come again to judge the quick and the dead. And do ye believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the remission of sins, the resurrection of the flesh, and everlasting life after death?
All this we steadfastly believe.
Now therefore let us together pray to God as our Lord Jesus Christ hath taught us, and say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath regenerated us by water and the Holy Ghost, and hath given unto us forgiveness of all our sins, himself guard us by his grace unto everlasting life, in the same Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.